sources. So I have a very personal and a very strong institutional desire and interest in listening to the views of our panelists today. So I'm now going to hand over the floor without more ado to our distinguished panelists. I'm going to ask Minister Guerra to kick us off. I think the panelists will use the podiums to start with to speak from. Minister Guerra has some slides as well that he'll talk to. And then afterwards, I really hope we'll get some time for Q&A. We have to finish sharp at 10:15. Over to you, Minister Guerra.
Thank you, good morning. I thank Dr. Bashawi for this kind invitation. And of course, it is an honor to be here, and it is an honor to share this panel with these distinguished colleagues. I have a presentation in PowerPoint because they asked me to share with you what we are doing in Mexico. Of course, I am confident that in Paris we will reach an agreement, but in the meantime, we believe that each country has to do the homework. And I want to show you what we are doing in Mexico, because I do believe that we are doing our homework. Please, the next chart. Of course, Mexico has a big, big concern about the climate change, because the next chart, please, because as you will see, we are a small emitter of greenhouse gases, but still, we are one of the most affected countries. Please, the next chart. We have been hit by heat waves. We have had severe rainstorms and 59 tropical cyclones. 31 of them were major hurricanes. In September 2013, we have, for the first time in many, many years, two hurricanes hitting Mexico at the same time. It devastated the state of Guerrero because two hurricanes hitting at the same time. And also, this last year, we have a hurricane hitting Baja California in the south, Baja California south in the peninsula. What is strange is that for many years in Baja we didn't have any hurricane, but this year we had one hitting directly the peninsula, and there were another three that at the very end, instead of turning east, they turned west and they went away to the Pacific. But still, we have to face the fact that we are going to be facing extreme situations, extreme hurricanes like those we have in the past, in the near past. Next chart, please. This shows the position of Mexico. We are in the middle of the two oceans, and that's why that makes us a very vulnerable country. The next chart, please. You see the root of the hurricanes, and that puts Mexico in the middle of hurricane center. Next one, please. Now, as I said, we think we are doing our homework because we are already reducing emissions. We made in 2010 a calculation of total emissions of Mexico that was close to 750 million of CO2 equivalent of tons. But we made a new calculation last year. We recalculated 2010 with the new technology, with more information, and we figured out that really our emissions were not 750 million tons, but they were 637. But the good news is that we calculated what we have produced in 2013, and the good news is that we are already reducing emissions by 4.5%. Next, please. And this is what the sector where we are getting emissions. Of course, we in the government are focusing on transportation and in power plants. Maybe, I don't know if you are familiar, but Mexico, President Peña produced an energy deal last year that opened the energy market to private investors. For many years, the energy market in Mexico, the energy sector, was closed only to the government. Tanto Petróleos Mexicanos como Comisión Federal de Electricidad had to be owned 100% by the government. Now, thanks to this new bill, the market of energy is open to all kinds of private investment. And we are promoting the switching of the fuel in vehicles from diesel and gasoline, and gasoline to natural gas, because Mexico has an abundant quantity of natural gas. Also, in relation with power plants, the energy company Comisión Federal de Electricidad is switching the 100% of its plants from coal and fuel oil to natural gas. This will make a sharp reduction on emissions, and of course that will allow us to reach the goal that the general law on climate change established to Mexico. Also, my country has a tremendous potential for geothermic energy, and this commission is going to build in these next futures new plants to produce geothermic energy, which is by sure one of the best ways to produce this kind of energy. Next one. And the next one. This is the one. We have a law, we have a general law on climate change in Mexico, and this law allows us to reduce, or force us to reduce 30% the emissions in the year 2020 and 50% in the year 2050. I'm sure that with the new policies and the new efforts we're doing in my country, we will reach this target, which is important not only for Mexico, but for the whole world. Thank you.